Right, dickheads, I'm your chunky messiah, Ethan, and I'm just here with, I guess, a bit of an old impressions, although me actually expressing an impression of this is kind of pointless. I don't need to make a video to talk about my opinion of this game. I don't need to have even played the 4 hours of it that I've already played to give you my impressions. I'll give you my impressions right up off the bat, and then I'm just gonna witter for the next 20 minutes, half an hour, however long this video ends up being, so I'll, yeah, just warn you that right now. This is, of course, Persona 4 The Golden, the PC release, the very much unexpected PC release, and I'm gonna tell you right now, if you haven't bought it already, stop watching the video, go buy it, go play it. Persona 4 is one of the best games ever made. Persona 4 is one of my all-time favorite games, and I want everyone in Christendom, I want everyone in the world to buy this fucking thing in order to convince Atlus to bring the rest of the franchise to Steam. If Persona 3 FES gets on Steam, if Persona 5 The Royal gets on Steam, you have no idea how happy I'll be. Atlus is a company that has inexplicably said that they thought there is no audience for the Persona games on PC. They are fucking idiots. They are incorrect. I saw within seconds of this game being released on Steam, it became a top seller. It sold like nobody's business. But anyway, yeah, it's fucking great. There's my opinion. If you don't want to hear me witter about the game, just go away. There it is. Go buy the game. It's absolutely fantastic. Absolutely great. Its port is pretty damn good, if I do say so myself. I will say it does actually have a couple of small peculiarities that can make it a bit of an annoyance. I've had a few crashes. It technically does have, you can see that I've got button prompts for an Xbox 360 or Xbox One controller. It does actually have the PS4 prompts in the game somewhere, but getting them to actually work is really obnoxious. And it also apparently for some people has some issues with stuttering in the anime cutscenes. But I've not had those issues. I can't speak to how prevalent they really are. I've been having a great time with this game. Absolutely fantastic time with it. I feel out of place if I don't give some kind of introduction to this game, in case you somehow are watching this and have not played the Persona games before. So I'll give you a brief explanation. The Persona series is a series of JRPGs that are technically technically a spin-off of the Shin Megami Tensei franchise, although it's fair to say that the Persona series has more or less completely eclipsed the popularity of the main SMT games. With Persona 4 specifically, I think, being the game that massively rocketed it to the kind of, not like massive, like huge mainstream success, but kind of put it as something in the relative mainstream. Persona 3 was a cult classic, but Persona 4 is where it, and I love Persona 3, but Persona 4 is the one where eyes really got on this particular subgenre, this particular subset of the franchise. The Persona games from 3 onwards, because 1 and 2 are a whole different kettle of fish, are essentially a kind of peculiar mix of almost Pokemon-esque JRPG, you know, traveling through dungeons, collecting monsters, or in this case, personas that are the means through which you get your magic attacks and a lot of your stats. Although you do have some abilities and stats that are unrelated to personas. So it's got that standard JRPG system, but it's that combined with... It's that combined with a kind of almost semi-visual novel life simulator kind of situation. That's what the Persona games are. Each of them follows a different... ooh, hello. No, get back here, you little twat! Motherfucker, I got teleported away. That's infuriating. But, each of them follows a different set of high schoolers as some kind of peculiar mystery envelops the town that they inhabit, the place that they come from. And said mystery is often a deadly and dangerous one and forces them to interact with the supernatural, fighting things known as shadows, such as this fellow, with other mystical powers known as personas. It's very much got a big aspect of it that's vaguely psychological. The shadows are, depending on which game, the exact explanation for them differs, but generally they're accepted to be kind of repressed or warped forms of kind of the darker side of the people in the town or the people in the world, while personas are basically their pure form. If someone accepts, in Persona 4 specifically, when someone accepts their dark side in this alternate world, they gain the power of Persona. Okay, I have no idea what this thing's going to be weak to, so let's just test it out here. The game's combat is a fairly simple affair. As you can see, it does follow your pretty standard JRPG tropes. You've got, standard attack, you've got guarding, and then you've got the skills which are attached to the personas, the attack and guard is what you can do anyway. Most of the party can only use the one persona that they have attached to them, such as Yosuke here is only able to use Jiraiya, although later on in the game, Jiraiya can essentially level up or evolve into a more powerful upgraded form of the same persona, with the exception of the main character himself, who in my game is called Kotaro Fuma, because that's just, if a game set in Japan needs me to name someone, I just always call them Kotaro Fuma, because I don't, because I recognize that name as a figure from the Sengoku Jidai, and I don't know, I'm not good at making up like Japanese sounding names, so I just go with the one I can always remember, Kotaro Fuma. The game is very heavily based around essentially the use of elemental weaknesses with the various shadows. I'm hoping I'll be able to exploit one, because essentially what you ideally want to be doing when you're fighting any group of shadows or individual shadow is find the element that it is weak to, because hitting it with that element will cause it to be knocked to the ground, allowing you to do an all-out attack, which does a lot of bonus damage. Although you can only do the all-out attacks if... There we go, this one's weak to ice. If everything that you're fighting is down. Even if you don't have the weakness, critical attacks will also knock the enemy over. So, of course, you have to balance that with the fact that your party can also be hit with such things. And, of course, here we have shuffle time, which is a means of getting bonus rewards, including getting more... personas. I will say that this system has actually been upgraded. There's a lot of stuff. Persona 4 Golden is essentially an expanded version of the original Persona 4, and I have never played Persona 4 the Golden because I and frankly most people didn't own a PS Vita, and it was a PS Vita exclusive, which meant that despite the fact that it is a very beloved game, the original Persona 4 is, most people didn't get to play this expanded version of it. Which honestly makes, for me, it's been making this more or less a pretty new feeling experience for me. And it's also expanded, at least to my memory, the shuffle time here with extra Arcana cards that can give you different effects. And also adding this system of a sweep bonus, where you can choose, we don't have a negative one here, but you can choose negative effects, such as half the XP you gain, or half the money you gain, to get extra tries to draw more of the cards out of the shuffle. If I remember correctly, in the original game, you only ever drew one card. I may be wrong there, it's been years since I played the original Persona 4. But I know for a fact it didn't have this shuffle sweep thing. If you are able to use those to basically claim every card in the that's presented to you, you get a shuffle sweep, which means that the next fight you have will always trigger a shuffle time. Normally, it's a chance that's greatly improved by defeating the enemy via an all-out attack. But it will also give you a bonus, an extra two draws, and get rid of any negative effects on any of the cards, and I think generally upgrade them. It's just an objectively better thing, which to my mind means if you can, you always want to be going for the sweep. Let's just pick this one just to see what we get there. Okay, let's also change something to a persona, and that's changed to Apsaris, which is a persona I already have, but that I've already unlocked, but fuck it, we might as well get Apsaris, because a lot of this game revolves around the fusion and the fusion of lesser personas to make more powerful upgraded personas. That's kind of one of the main the means of upgrading your character, and one of the main kind of gameplay loops here. But yeah, the game is basically equal halves traveling through these dungeons that are constructed from the psyche of people who have been unfortunately thrown into a television world, hence the static and the fact that there was TVs earlier and we had to meet a supermarket because we have to get into the TV world via the same TV that happens to be in that supermarket. Oh, hello. We have no chance of killing this thing.
A rare monster!
I'm almost
beat the
certain.
Stuffing out of it.
Our only chance of killing this thing is getting a crit, because if I recall correctly, this specific monster, if you're able to kill it,
some thick skin.
Yeah, if you're able to kill this thing, you get a great reward.
It's not going down.
Someone finish it off!
The issue is that, as far as I can recall, the only damage that really hurts it is a damage type known as Almighty, which you can only do with a very high level spell, or
all right, guys. Okay.
This, or the all-out attack. The all-out attack also does Almighty damage. And yet that did 123 damage.
It's another enemy! Show them what you've got!
Oh. I know what breaks you, though, don't I? Yeah, you're allergic to ice. I cannot remember which of my guys has ice. Senri. Okay. Change our persona there.
Persona!
And summon up Senri.
It's down!
Give another all-out attack. And yeah, you can actually tell when the all-out attack is not going to successfully kill the monster. Because the animation's just slightly different. The animation shows basically you being kicked away from it when the all-out attack isn't going to succeed. And we got another shuffle time, I assume, because of our lad. And... damn it. Okay, money up. And yeah, we could not get a sweep, unfortunately. But yeah, that's what I meant when I said about negative powers. There's cards that do just lower the XP you gain. And lower in exchange for two other things. In exchange for two other draws, which is quite a nice one, that. Okay, I am also aware that I am basically... Oh, wait, I don't want to be using him. I want to be using Yusuke, because our character's SP just, like, our skill points just... they just objectively matter more, I'm afraid. And yeah, this floor is specifically a bit peculiar. This is a floor that's got a mini-boss on it. So, yeah, that's why we are kind of doing all this teleporting around stuff. I will say I'm still not sure which of the Persona games I would honestly say is my favorite. Because the peculiar thing is that there's a certain desire to just say that my favorite of the Persona games, motherfucker, that my favorite of the Persona games is just honestly the most recent one that's come out, and I am a very big fan of Persona 5. I actually, unfortunately, have not been able to play Persona 5 The Royal. As of yet, because I don't have access to my PS4, and even if I did, I wouldn't actually be able to play it, because I no longer have a television.
This one's really strong.
What the hell are you allergic to?
Don't.
Zio. That's lightning. Did I give you Zio? Yeah, you have Zio. Let's change personas. That.
Two enemies left.
Persona.
My big angry horse.
Go, Sensei!
Basically summoning YMS's persona is this thing, Aurelia.
You hit its weakness!
Good answer!
But yeah, I don't currently have access to a television, so I've not been able to play Persona 5 Royal. I mean, I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm sat here, fingers crossed, praying that the success of this will cause Persona... because Persona 5 The Royal to come out. Let's get skill card. We don't need the angel. And yeah, we lower our XP again, but we get skill card and Sandman persona.
Congratulations, Sensei!
And cool, we level up. You are limited to the personas you can create by your level. You can only create personas that are of a level equal to or lower than yours. Although, the visual novel life sim side of the game does directly feed into the combat side of the game.
Electricity.
Weak against lightning. Weak against.
Three enemies left!
But it does directly, but yeah, the life sim does directly feed into combat part of the game, because when you are creating personas, the closer you are to the various NPCs you represent different arcanas that the various personas are a part of. The closer you are to those characters, the more power you can give to these personas upon their creation, which can in fact lead to them being more powerful than they should be able to be. We're getting a sweep bonus. Card of Sun Arcana, decrease the money, increase that XP though, and give me another persona. One which I've already collected, but I'm not gonna say no. And of course we get a Snuff Soul there as well, just something to get us a bit more SP. I can't remember how I got through this before. I genuinely can't. It's definitely not that way. Because I'm pretty sure I have to get through that door. But I can't remember how we get to that door.
I smell two enemies!
Hello! The shadows are a bit of a
sensei.
That was something I did miss in Persona 5, was the shadows, because there aren't... Shadows exist in that game, but they don't look like them. The shadows in that game, because it basically incorporated an older mechanic, that was also from the old Shin Megami Tensei games. I believe you found it a lot in Nocturne or Lucifer's Call, depending on how, you know, where you were. That game had different names, where you essentially negotiated with the demons in that game. Persona 5 has the same system in it. And yeah, okay, we just got two sweet bonuses in a row. That's always good. Release the angel.
Another level for me!
You can only carry X number of personas at a time. It's always a good idea to keep a few slots empty when you go through areas so you can pick up some new ones. Yeah, because I've always been a big fan of the very weird looks associated with the shadows, with the shadow enemies in this franchise. But in Persona 5, they're just not there, because everything just looks like your personas, because you literally hire them straight from the map.
That's a strong enemy!
Oh dear, okay,
it's
this
really
boy is
strong.
Annoying.
Because
we are unable to actually, do anything to this guy. So what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to swap over to Senri, because if I recall correctly,
one
this
enemy.
Guy uses...
Fight!
This guy does some big, scary fire damage, and thankfully, Senri is literally immune to fire. So what we're going to do is have these guys attack and then put her on guard. Good idea, because she is weak to fire, because her persona has got ice powers, so letting her get hit would have been a dangerous situation for us. Would have fucked her up quite badly if she had been hit by that. And we're on the way to a boss, so we kind of want to be doing that. And okay, we are about to get another sweep. And also we got two things that level up our persona, which is fantastic. Absolutely fabulous stuff to get. I love it. This leads to a boss fight, it is worth saying, actually, that the Shin Megami Tensei games, and Persona is no exception to this, are kind of infamous at times for the fact that their boss fights are very, you either do it exactly as was intended, or you die. Their bosses a lot of the time have very specific reactions, and here we are with a bit of a mini-boss. And yeah, we're being attacked by a mini-boss here.
One enemy!
The looks of it, I seem to recall this thing turns into... I seem to recall that it turns into a standard enemy later on down the line.
Just one enemy left!
At higher levels. Okay, so let's go through the old standard of trying everything on it. See if it's got an elemental weakness. It's honestly rare, to my memory, for bosses to have particularly immediately potent elemental weaknesses. Simply because that would make them too easy. But yeah, we are early enough in the game for the bosses and mini-bosses to still be subject to some pretty solid elemental weaknesses. You know what? I very rarely do this. It's always something that struck me as really peculiar. This one allies attack. Do that to ourselves, though. It's always struck me as peculiar about the these games that, he's resistant to fire. What a shame. Nullifies, all stat bonuses, all like physical damage. Yeah, the physical attacks actually drain your health rather than draining your SP, which has always been a peculiar one. And yep, we've enraged him, which is mixed. You can also silence him there. Oh, we missed. Well, we tried. Let's skewer him.
Couldn't quite beat it.
And the knight is enraged, which, if I recall correctly, literally just means that he is going to only punch things, if I recall correctly. You know what? I'm going to swap over to slime there, because this guy can only attack us. Evil touch, instill fear, bash. Yeah, fuck it. Bash the fucker. That sounds like a crit. Fantastic. I love accidentally getting a crit with a really low-level persona. That's always absolutely fantastic. Yeah, just keep beating it up.
It's not going down.
Literally no reason to do anything else.
How's that?
Cool, mini boss defeated. And we have the surge, so we have leveled up once again. You do level up quite quickly early on in this game, it's worth saying. Slows down a fair bit later on. Oh, he leveled up like twice. Red wall. That's going to be a nice spell to have, because it's always good to be able to take advantage of, or be able to basically nullify your own elemental weaknesses. That's something you always want to get hold of. And I am hoping that the defeat of that boss means that we are no longer going to get teleported around. Yeah, it seems like it. It's also worth noting, the way you engage enemies
One
in the
enemy.
Actual dungeon does matter. Just so that's clear. If an enemy hits you, they get basically a surprise round, to borrow the D&D terminology. If you're able to whack them in the back, you get a surprise round on them. If you're just able to hit them in the face or at the side, it just kind of is standard. That's just the generic one that you ideally want. I have immediately forgotten what you're weak against. Honestly, I should have expected that. You are... Actually, you know what? No, I'm gonna...
Fight!
That's some thick skin.
There we are. I'm gonna use her. I don't wanna waste all of
It's down.
The pro Here all the pro tags SP there. Ooh, it's alive. Okay, well we'll use pro tags SP this time. There we are. kill it there. And shuffle time. Is this the sweep bonus? Yeah, it's the sweep bonus. Oh, fuck me running. We can get another sweep bonus. Yep, Sunakana, lose some money. Sword, get an extra ability, get extra XP. And the pixie, which I simply don't need. Because I already have the pixie in my persona compendium. And there is no reason to take another one. Because I can literally just buy them from the compendium from now on. Quite know why that door was locked before the boss fight. That's a slightly peculiar one. Okay, that's the way down. We need to go find the way back up. But yeah, I was not expecting this game to come out on PC ever, really. It's always been something I'd hoped for, but it's never been something that I'd actually expected to happen.
I smell two enemies.
You're weak to lightning. But it's not something I'd ever actually expected to happen, for the simple reason that Atlas has never been particularly great about PC. In fact, the situation leading up to it, in case you weren't aware, the situation leading up to it was a bit of a peculiar one, because essentially there was some data mining and leaks a couple of days before it came out. About 3 days before it came out, some data mining, like someone was obviously, as people do, going through, you know, Steam's databases and stuff, and they found an entry for Persona 4. Now, that's not... Damn it. Ooh, hello. And yep, another sweet bonus. And yep, get that chest key, and that's a patient. And I will happily replace Ukuba with you, because again, Ukuba is an enemy, is a persona I already have. That's fantastic. She is a very melee-focused character, it's worth saying. But, yeah, no, there were some leaks there, but then people found, like, a Persona 4 entry in the Steam database. But that doesn't honestly mean much. I mean, Bloodborne has an entry. You know, like, there's plenty of games that have never come out on Steam and seem like they will never come out on Steam that have had Steam Store database entries for a long time. I assume just someone at Steam going, I don't know, it might happen. I don't know, it might happen, could be fun. So, I guess that's what was happening there, so that didn't prove anything. But then, someone who was only described as an insider mentioned that there was some...
Hang in there!
You know what, I am actually going to hit this guy, with a spell, just so he's... So they're both a bit weaker, so we can ideally actually kill them.
It's not going down!
Two enemies left!
And boo-foo this fella. But yeah, someone just claimed that they were going to... A so-called insider claimed that this game was coming out actually 3 days after the leak happened, claiming that it was going to be shown off in a stream at like a big game reveal thing, and that after it was shown off, it was going to be displayed there, and that it was literally going to be released at the same time as it being shown off, and that ended up just being true. So it went out from, and there was also an announcement a couple of days before that claiming, from Atlas, claiming that something big was going to be announced. Oh, hello.
A rare monster! Beat the stuffing out of it!
We have got literally...
Some thick skin.
Zero chance.
Let's get through this.
Someone
of succeeding in this situation. In fact, I reckon I'm actually gonna. Flee here because we are not beating three of these things. It's not dangerous. It's just a waste of my time. But, oh, and yep, we got, thankfully we have a shitload of chest keys. And we got a vault suppressor accessory. Fan-dabby-dozy. Hang on, a vault suppressor? Raises evasion rate to electric attacks. Yes, please, let's put that on Yosuke, because he is, yeah, he's weak to electric, so having him less likely to be hit is, definitely gonna help. I would prefer immunity, but that seems unlikely. But yeah, that was just a peculiar thing, is that it was leaked and then announced, and then just came out on the same day. It's, yeah, really took a lot of people by surprise, really took me by surprise, certainly. But not exactly an unwelcome surprise. A very, very welcome surprise, and I hope we get more welcome surprises like that in the in DOS future, because I would very happily have... I'll say this right now, I will buy...
There's one enemy!
Every single Persona game, if they are released on...
It's not going down!
Just one enemy
on
left!
I will buy all
it's
of
tough.
Them. Swap back over to Senri there, just so we can survive. He's going to cast Aggie Lao at us, which is Aggie
down.
Big, essentially. Oh, no, he's going to cast Miragi, the multiple one. Yeah, the names for a lot of the abilities in this series are a bit peculiar, but you do... If you play enough Persona, you learn them, and they stop being surprising or odd. Okay, we are finally coming to the end of our sequence of swoops there. It had to happen someday, didn't it? And we got ourselves a life stone. We are also, actually, I'm going to say, drawing to the close of this episode, so I'm just going to finish by talking about something that was basically asked of me in the Discord. Oh, hello.
I smell two enemies. Beat them up.
I don't like that. I actually recognize that shadow. I think it might be allergic to, lightning or wind.
Two enemies left!
That one.
Come on!
Because it's got both
it's
ice.
Go! Good move, Chie-chan!
Yeah, because it's got both
ice, it's tough.
Ice and, fire powers, so I think that might be a little bit
soda. No one stands
well, it's
in
dead
Sensei's
anyway.
Way.
So I guess it doesn't really matter that much.
Oh, Chie-chan, that was beautiful!
That's some thick skin.
Oh, looks like we'll be getting ourselves. But yeah, I'm going to address one of the things that
it's
got asked
down.
Me basically as soon as I
All right, gotcha.
Said that I picked this game up. And that something is the question of whether or not I'm going to do a full series on it. It's obviously not going to be soon, because I'm just playing it through myself at the moment, and I'm not of a mind to play it, like, two saves of it at the same time, especially considering this is a JRPG that, yeah, this game runs into the, like, hundreds of hours, if you follow it to the end. It's a big, yeah, this game's a big lab, as they all are, to be honest. All the Persona games are big boys. So it wouldn't be for a while. But as to whether or not I would consider doing a series on this, the answer to that is definitely. Absolutely definitely there will be a series on this before at some point in the future. Some of you may recall that...
Two enemies! Charge through them!
It's not going down!
That quite some time ago, many years ago, I attempted a Let's Play of Persona 3 FES, and got quite a good ways into that, but I ultimately was not able to finish that. The simple reason for that being that, way back when, in the annals of time, I was required to, play that on a console and use a Dazzle capture card. To try to record
Sensei.
That, and I had no end of technical issues with Persona 3. So I ended up giving up on that series, not because I couldn't bring myself to... What the fuck? Gentleman's tux. All right. Unfortunately, it doesn't change our actual appearance. There is actually a means to get costumes at the moment, which, if I recall correctly, I think this is a standard part of like Persona 3 and 4, in that the base game doesn't have costumes, but the final form, the traditional updated, almost like, you know, Game of the Year edition, update, fancier version that comes out later on, does have costumes in it. Although I think Persona 5 had costumes in it anyway. But yeah, I will be doing a series of Persona 4 at some point in the future. I do not know when,
you can attack
but it will
that.
Happen. And ideally, what I'll be doing
two
is I'll be doing it as,
someone turn.
Someone finish it off!
That's some thick skin.
But ideally,
someone else's turn.
I'll be doing it in ye olde
awesome.
New Game Plus as well, so I'll have much higher stats and be able to basically take advantage of all the little peculiarities. There are a number of events you literally. Oh, hello.
Let's go.
Yeah, alright, I'll take that for it. There are a number of events and such like that happen early on in the game that require stat checks that you have no way to possibly have beaten. So if I was to attempt to.
I couldn't quite beat it.
See, if I was to attempt a series of this, it would ideally be a New Game Plus, so I could show everyone or as many of the events as possible, while also, it also would mean I wouldn't have to spend that much time grinding out stats, like social stats, not mechanical stats, because yeah, the life sim involves you having to like improve your like diligence and your charisma and your knowledge and stuff like, in fact, actually, wait a minute. Status. Is that on? Where is it? It's on social links? There it is, yeah. Courage, knowledge, expression, understanding, and diligence. But yeah, normally if you play the game correctly, by the end of the story the first time, you'll have pretty damn high stats. So when you go into New Game Plus with all those stats and with a bunch of extra stuff unlocked, while also facing, I think, more dangerous enemies. Just like it's just
two enemy
as
shadows.
You may expect,
you get to go first.
A tougher form of the same game. I just think that'd be a more interesting thing
go,
to watch
that's how it's done. You knocked it down.
Than just you know me. Playing this.
You hit its weakness!
Now
playing like the standard. And it would hold my interest more as long as I'd be seeing stuff that I'd not seen before. Rather than just.
It's not going down!
Two enemies! Charge through them!
Rather than just having to,
Awesome!
Atta girl!
Chan's in rampage mode!
Rather than just having to talk over stuff I'm already evident and familiar with. We'll see, there is enough new stuff and new surprises that. Oh, hello. Please don't change the higher. Damn it! Still change it to something new. I mean, I'll take that. And who can we replace it with? We will replace that with. Apsaris. Because, again, we already have an Apsaris, and we've already done a fusion with an Apsaris. But, yeah, no, so that'd be the plan in terms of this becoming a possible series somewhere down the line. I reckon what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue this video and, oh my god.
Two enemies! You can attack before them!
You see, this shit is why I like the shadow designs and why I miss them. In Persona 5, because look at this silly shit.
Persona! Someone else's turn.
Two enemies, charge through them.
Positive kick.
Yikes, it's tough.
Uh, Oh, I think I might know what these guys do. Beyond fire, wind, air, and
enemy reinforcements.
Other nonsense. There are he's fucking immediately turned into a new thing. There are two others. There's light and dark, and then almighty. Everything's weird. And given the name Positive King, it wouldn't surprise me if these guys are
three enemies. Let's get through this.
Dark. The problem with that. Is that, I don't think I've got anything that does dark at the moment. Let's try and poison the knight. Didn't work. But the problem with that is I don't currently actually have anything that, does that shit. Just trying to find one of these guys if we have some summoning stuff. No, we can't. Okay. Skullcracker might make them panic. Let's try this.
Yikes, it's
tough. There we are. That's good.
An enemy escaped. Only two left.
Fucking dare you. Okay, let's go back to Moroboros here, and, I know it's not, it's Orobas or something, but I keep saying Ouroboros. And, yeah, let's get hysterical flat, see if we can't make this guy enrage.
Two enemies left!
Nope, it's looking like we cannot enrage him. That's a shame.
Damn, it's not going down!
I was hoping for him to be very, very angry indeed. He's dead anyway, so
that's one!
Oh good, he just threw money away. That sucks a lot worse if it happens to us, by the way, just so...
Just one enemy left!
Just so you're aware. And yeah, fuck it. Let's see if we can't get Aggie on this guy. I don't know if the red wall is still present. Yeah, the red wall is still present.
It's not going down.
That's a shame.
Yikes, it's tough!
Oh, Chi-Chan,
how fucking dare you! Shuffle time! And yeah, we'll improve the agility there, might as well. And level up again, and he gets dodge ice, which is a nice one, because he is, again, weak to ice. Okay, those are the stairs up. It's another thing, which I can't remember if it was something that was in the base game, if it's a quality of life improvement that's unique to Persona 4 The Golden, but you literally have an ability to tell the party that you are returning to, just decide at any moment that you are going up to the next floor, so you don't actually need to navigate your way back through the...
I smell three enemies!
You don't actually
careless.
Need to navigate your way back through the area, which is always a fun one.
It's not strong at all! I'm sure you can win! Three enemies!
Do I
Let's
have
get
some
through
of the Garu? Yeah, here we go, we've got some Garu. Okay, so it's not actually weak to anything, it seems.
Some thick skin.
You know what? This is definitely stupid, but let's try Bufu. It's unlikely, but.
Why didn't that
yeah, block,
work?
That's. What I thought, to be fair. Oh,
Sensei! How dare you!
Dare you.
Oh, Sensei's back on his feet!
Okay. Yeah, we're gonna swap back to Senri, so we're at least immune to one of their abilities. And now
no
we're just gonna try to kick
Sensei's
the fuck
way.
Out of them.
That's some thick skin!
Because...
Someone finish it off!
Frankly, that's all the options we have.
Two enemies left!
Good Yosuke's god. And yeah, I'm just gonna hit Rush,
keep
actually.
It going.
Sometimes you get into battles where...
Let's go,
oh, yeah, alright. Where all you really have is the ability to hit them. So then you just hit the Rush button and hope. We're getting lucky on the triple times right now. Yeah, there we are. Change one more to Arcana. And get a chest key. There we are. Sweet bonus. That's a sweet, sweet bonus. And there is at least, I'm fairly certain, one other enemy that we passed on the way here. And open up that chest key. We have a rabbit's foot, which if I were to take a random wild stab in the dark, I'd say improves our luck.
Two enemy shadows! You get to go first!
Okay.
Someone else's turn.
To be honest.
Someone finish it off!
Two enemies!
Could be worse.
Launch through them!
That's some thick skin.
Couldn't quite beat it.
And now I'm guessing they are both going to start. Oh, they only one of them started gathering power. The other one just went for it.
Attaboy, Yosuke! You're in the zone!
Someone else's turn.
Well, that was fun. And yeah, it's a good thing I put on that guy.
Just one enemy left!
Targeted the one that went.
Someone else's turn.
Whoops, did not mean to hit guard there. Ah, well.
Someone else's turn.
I mean, that time I need to hit guard. There we are.
Yosuke's in danger! He needs help!
That's some thick skin!
Yosuke barely has any health!
And I believe that is, this should be, this level of the dungeon is done. And, yep, change one Arcana. And get another sweet bonus. Although, I'm not sure if the sweet bonus is carry over to the next day. So that might have actually been a pointless.
Level for me.
Pointless fella. Ah, well, such is life. And with... No. I was about to leave. There's a chest. Oh, good. A shadow jumped out of the box. That's actually... I can't believe it, but that's actually helpful.
Don't get careless.
Heal up. Get him straight there so he doesn't go down.
Are you okay, Sensei? Someone heal him!
Yeah, let's just heal the party up a bit here. I'm gonna be honest, I just wasn't expecting, this kind of situation.
Three enemies left!
And, I mean, we're in rush mode here.
Hang tight and go for it!
We are literally just punching these things until they die at the moment.
Two enemies left!
Couldn't quite beat it.
Or in the case... Well, actually, I was going to say no one's actually doing any punching. Everyone's doing a lot
that
of...
That was cool, Yosuke!
It's just a lot of hitting with swords.
Someone else's turn.
Or in the case of Chie, kicking in the face.
Chie-chan is swatting them left and right!
There we go!
Go get him!
Took it 30 years, but we did eventually get that. And yeah, here we are. Sweet bonus. And we're gonna take that, we're gonna take you, and we're gonna take the money. There you go. Valkyrie. This is always the shame. You do get more slots for Persona as you reach higher levels, which is a good thing. But yeah, move on to the next floor, at which point... Yeah, this is...
Sensei, are you okay?
Literally...
Your health's low.
The boss floor for this dungeon. So, I'm going to use... the Go-Home to leave the dungeon. Okay, because I don't want to be fighting the boss in this, because I don't want to spoil anything for you. Okay, so, yeah. In conclusion, Persona 4, it fucking rocks. Persona 4 The Golden Fucking Rocks, go buy it on Steam right now. I will put a link in the description. It's one of the best games ever. Even if you've played Persona 4 before, but you never played Persona 4 The Golden, pick up Persona 4 The Golden on Steam. Because it is different enough that it is surprising me on the regs. Bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.